Listening Library presents DBT Skills for Teens with Anxiety, Practical Strategies to Manage Stress and Strengthen Emotional Resilience by Atara Hiller, PsyD. Read for you by Nadia, Verde. Note to listeners, this audiobook includes a downloadable PDF containing worksheets, tables, charts, and resources from the book. To the many teens I've treated with DBT over the years, your commitment to building a life worth living, despite the obstacles in your way, inspires me to keep doing this challenging and incredibly fulfilling work. How this audiobook can help. Over the past 30 years, dialectical behavior therapy, DBT, has helped millions of adults, teens, and children learn to manage their emotions more effectively. If you are listening to this audiobook, you have likely been struggling with anxiety. You might be feeling stressed and overwhelmed, experiencing panic attacks, avoiding certain places or situations, struggling with other anxiety-related symptoms, or all of the above. Whatever your stress and anxiety look like, the DBT skills in this audiobook can help you gain control of your emotions so they don't control you. Keep a separate notebook for doing the exercises and activities. This audiobook will teach you how to cope with stressful situations such as relationship conflicts, exams and essays, job interviews, the college application process, and everyday life problems. Make wise and effective choices even amid strong emotions. Focus more easily. Experience emotions without acting on them in problematic ways. Identify and work toward short and long-term goals. Build more positive experiences. Reduce your risk of negative emotions by maintaining your physical well-being. Communicate better. Think about and respond to situations more flexibly. Overcome rejection and failures and increase self-esteem and self-compassion. Although the teenage years can be tough, your future is unwritten and full of potential. With DBT, you can break free from chronic stress and anxiety and move forward with greater peace. Introduction. DBT Basics. Dialectical Behavior Therapy, DBT, is an effective treatment for people who struggle with emotions, including anxiety, depression, anger, and shame. DBT was developed by a psychologist named Marsha Linehan, and it is an evidence-based treatment, meaning that there has been a lot of research showing it is helpful for people with borderline personality disorder, BPD. BPD is characterized by chronic difficulties with thoughts, emotions, behaviors, identity, and relationships with others. People with BPD often struggle with other problems, including anxiety. DBT is shown to help treat these difficulties in adults and teens, even if they don't have BPD. What makes DBT so helpful? For many people, it's the DBT skills which teach people to control their emotions and manage their lives more effectively. In fact, DBT includes 5 modules of life skills that can be particularly helpful if you are often stressed. Mindfulness helps us stay present in the moment, which is often less stressful than what we are worrying about. Distress tolerance helps us cope with difficult situations without responding in a way that makes things harder for us in the long term. Emotion regulation helps us reduce the likelihood that we will experience intense emotions and allows us to decrease unwanted intense emotions after they start. Interpersonal effectiveness helps us be more successful in our interactions with others, so we're more likely to get what we want, build and maintain relationships, and feel good about ourselves. Walking the middle path helps us think and feel more flexibly and be more open-minded about situations so we can be more effective in dealing with them. I personally find DBT skills to be incredibly helpful and studied the works of Dr. Linehan, Dr. Jill Rathis, and Dr. Alex Miller, who adapted DBT to treat adolescents so I could share DBT with my clients. As a licensed psychologist, I exclusively use DBT to treat teens and young adults who struggle with their emotions, and I train other mental health professionals on how to provide DBT. In all my years of doing DBT, I've seen it dramatically change people's lives for the better. I worked with one teen who struggled with severe social anxiety. She was constantly worried about what people thought of her, how to talk to people, and whether she said the wrong thing when she did speak. She also yearned for a major role in her school's annual theater performance, but had always been too anxious to try out. By learning and utilizing various DBT skills, she learned to control her emotions and worry thoughts more effectively and was able to focus more on her schoolwork, develop meaningful friendships with confidence, and, most impressively, steal the show in a leading role in her school's play. Another teen had a hard time focusing on anything because she was always worrying about something: the health of her family, current events, upcoming tests, or friends being mad at her. DBT skills helped her rein in her distress so it didn't consume her, and also enabled her to focus more on her goals and relationships than on her worries. For serious or persistent anxiety, there are comprehensive adolescent DBT programs, but they generally require a minimum of 6 months of individual and group therapy. However, even the DBT skills in this audiobook can help you manage your stress at home. As a teenager, you have a lot to manage, like schoolwork, extracurricular activities, jobs, and relationships. When you're struggling with anxiety, it makes all of those things even harder and more exhausting. But taking the time and energy to learn and practice these skills can make your life a lot easier and more enjoyable without the burden of chronic stress and anxiety weighing you down. Part 1. DBT Skill Sets. The next 5 chapters will introduce DBT skill sets based on the 5 modules mentioned on the introduction: mindfulness, distress tolerance, emotion regulation, interpersonal effectiveness, and walking the middle path. Each chapter includes various activities you can do to practice the skills and add them to your coping toolbox. The more you practice the skills, the easier they will become to implement whenever you need them. The material in these chapters is based on the work of Marcia Linehan, PhD, and Alec Miller, PhD, and Jill Rathis, PhD, who adapted DBT for adolescents. The skills and their descriptions have been tailored to focus on teens with anxiety, and they've been made more approachable for people who can't access a DBT therapist right now. The skills are listed in a particular order for a reason, but feel free to listen to this audiobook and use it in a way that works for you. Please don't feel bound to listen to this audiobook in the order provided. Chapter 1. See Clearly with Mindfulness. When we feel anxious and stressed, we're often thinking about the past or worrying about the future. Mindfulness helps us stay present in the moment right now. By slowing down and being aware of our current thoughts, emotions, sensations, and urges without judging them, you can respond thoughtfully rather than impulsively. Mindfulness skills are the foundation for all the other skills in this audiobook because, as Dr. Linehan astutely observed when developing DBT, you need mindfulness to identify what you're feeling and why. If you aren't aware of what's causing your distress, you can't use skills to deal with it. Let's get mindful. Mindfulness skills in action. Olivia's mind was always filled with negative self-judgments, resulting in chronic stress and headaches. To stop the constant negative thinking, Olivia learned to mindfully observe her thoughts and notice when she treated a negative thought like a fact. When Olivia saw pictures of her friends hanging out without her, she caught herself thinking, they must not like me. Instead of believing this thought, she reframed it as, I'm having the thought that no one likes me. This approach helped Olivia react differently and, in turn, feel more positive about herself. She used other DBT skills to ask her friends about the pictures. It turns out there was a valid reason why she was not included. Elijah struggled with procrastination. For a long time, he attributed this behavior to being lazy. Recently, he learned to mind.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.